Just a friendly reminder to please grab a worship aid if you haven't done so. They are in each of the entrances of the church. Thank you.
And the second.
The second is here?
No, we just a minute.
That's that one there.
It's the first right here. Oh, the second one is where the string is. Okay, so you got one, this one, and then you put the string, and then you put that one, okay?
Yep.
Good morning and welcome to St. Edward's for our celebration of Thanksgiving. Before we begin, we ask that you please silence your cell phones. Thank you. Our presider this morning is Father Rick. Please join us in singing our opening song, found in your worship aid, All Praise and Glad Thanksgiving.
Praise and glad thanksgiving to God. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we gather this morning on this day when our nation pauses to give thanks to God, we take a moment to pause and reflect on those times that we've sinned, so that we might prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and your blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, all-powerful, your gifts of love are countless and your goodness infinite. As we come before you on Thanksgiving Day with gratitude for your kindness, open our hearts to have concern for every man, woman, and child so that we may share your gifts in loving service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. King Solomon stood and blessed the whole congregation of Israel, saying in a loud voice, "Blessed be the Lord, who has given rest to his people Israel, just as he promised. Not a single word has gone unfulfilled of the entire generous promise he made through his servant Moses. May the Lord our God be with us as he was with our fathers, and may he not forsake us nor cast us off. May he draw our hearts to himself, that we may follow him in everything and keep the commands, statutes, and ordinances which he enjoined on our fathers. May this prayer I have offered to the Lord our God be present to him day and night, that he may uphold the cause of his servant and of his people Israel as each day requires, that all the peoples of the earth may know the Lord is God, and there is no other. You must be wholly devoted to the Lord our God, observing his statutes and keeping his commandments as on this day." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory. Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below? Blessed be the name of the Lord forever. He raises up the lowly from the dust, From the dunghill he lifts up the poor to seat them with princes, with the princes of his own people.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift, as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you are called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Circumstances, give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 persons with leprosy met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." When he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourself to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
I probably say this far too frequently, but that's one of my favorite gospel readings because it just really gets to the heart of gratitude and not taking the many blessings of the Lord for granted. I just wanted to touch just very briefly this morning on a couple of items. One is to look at Thanksgiving itself. We always have the vision in our minds of the Pilgrim peoples and the Native Americans sitting down together, celebrating a feast of the harvest and sharing the bounty of the harvest that God has provided, a very peaceful and beautiful celebration. And that's a good thing. That's a good thing. But Thanksgiving itself, the official proclamation of Thanksgiving in this country, did not start until whose presidency? Anybody want to take a guess?
Lincoln.
Who didn't say Lincoln? You're wrong.
No, Lincoln, I didn't know this until I looked it up last night as I was just checking some things for this morning. But yes, it says Abraham Lincoln instituted the holiday in 1863 during the Civil War. So imagine that, you know, our country has gone through a lot in its almost 250 years, not quite 250 years, but the Civil War was really the worst, the most trying time for our country in terms of division amongst our peoples and all the rest. And here's what, just a very brief excerpt from Abraham Lincoln's proclamation that he wrote. He said, "I do therefore invite my fellow citizens in every part of the United States and also those who are at sea and those who are sojourning in foreign lands to set apart and observe the last Thursday of November as a day of thanksgiving and praise to our beneficent Father who dwelleth in the heavens." Short and sweet and to the point. And we've been celebrating Thanksgiving, all of us here, probably for all of our lives, unless we came perhaps from a country that does not celebrate this holiday as we do here. The thing I wanted to point out about Thanksgiving today is for all of us to try as best as we can to focus on our blessings and to focus on giving thanks. That seems obvious, that seems, you know, like something that doesn't need to be said, but just as I sat down and reflected on the things of my own life that I go through daily life and thinking of the things of your lives, you who, most of you who have families and relatives and in-laws and all of those kinds of things, you know, think of how much of our days are filled with stress, with anxiety, with worry. Think of within families, how often, sadly, there is bickering and disagreement, often about, well, sometimes there are things that are important, and sometimes they are things that are not so important. But the bottom line in that regard, I'll just give you a little example, because I was discussing this with parts of my family the last time I was home. And first, let me do a disclaimer. This isn't my family that I'm talking about, okay? But again, I don't want to bring up anything contentious, but I just want to give it as an example. You know, we've probably heard things on the news, and maybe this is even affecting us within our own families. You know, there's the whole situation is still going on with COVID. We still haven't said, unfortunately, we're done with this. But the whole thing with status of vaccination and not vaccination and booster and not booster and all the rest. And my mother and I and my sister were talking about some of our in-laws who were having a situation with Thanksgiving in terms of, you know, okay, well, we're having Thanksgiving and this member of the family is hosting it, but if you're not vaccinated, don't come. Okay, what do you do with that? What do you do with that? There could be legitimate reasons. There might not be legitimate reasons. But it's like, is there some way that we can find peace and harmony so that we can give thanks together, you know, on Thanksgiving Day? And I always say this, I speak of someone who's had COVID and who's been vaccinated. And, you know, we can come to some kind of agreement. You know, and all of the other things that are part of our life, if we're dealing with illness or a diagnosis of a disease or convalescing from some type of accident or injury or whatever it might be, let's just try as best as we can, not only as Christian disciples, but as families, to put all of the stuff that we deal with every other day of the year aside. As best as we can, I know it's not easy always, but put it aside, try as best as we can not to think of it, try as best as we can not to dwell on it, try as best as we can not to deal with disagreements or, you know, grinding our teeth about other members of the family and this and that and the other thing, but just put it all aside to take one day, 24 hours, not even 24 hours, because we'll be sleeping part of it, and focus on giving thanks to God for all our blessings. Because no matter what any of us may be going through, no matter what any of us may be suffering, we are so immensely blessed. And if we just take one day to put all the rest aside and to focus on that, I think it will enliven our hearts and enliven our spirits and perhaps help us to remember what is most truly important. In thanksgiving for all the ways the Father has blessed us, we present our needs before Him this day. For bishops, priests, and pastoral leaders in the church, may our Heavenly Father shed His wisdom and grace upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may God inspire them in working toward peace and the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all God's children, especially today, we remember those who lack the basic necessities of life. May their needs be met, and may they be blessed with strength and support, especially through people like us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our faith community who have recently lost a loved one, at this time of thanksgiving, may God comfort them in their grief. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For today's Mass intention, the repose of the soul of Kim Fouch, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all our beloved dead, may God welcome them with love and rejoicing into their eternal home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we place these petitions before you with trust in your holy will, asking that you answer them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
God, our Father, from whose hand we have received generous gifts, so that we might learn to share your blessings in gratitude, accept these gifts of bread and wine, and let the perfect sacrifice of Jesus draw us closer to all our brothers and sisters in the human family. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, you have entrusted to us the great gift of freedom, a gift that calls forth responsibility and commitment to the truth that all have a fundamental dignity before you. In Jesus, through his death and resurrection, we find our ultimate redemption, freedom from sin, and every blessing. And so, with hearts full of love, we join the angels today and every day of our lives to sing your glory as we acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Joints, no one can divide.
On behalf of Deacon Bill and Deacon Bob, I want to wish all of you a happy and blessed Thanksgiving. If you're traveling today, prayers for safe travels, or tomorrow or Saturday, continued prayers for safe travels. Good to see my old friend from Fort Wayne, John Becker, here to celebrate Thanksgiving with his family. John, I'm going to embarrass you. How old are you now? 88. Okay, God bless you. John and I and John's late wife, Jean, yes, go back to the 90s, to my early days with Allen County Right to Life. You'll find in the vestibule, if you didn't notice on your way in, the Advent books are already out. So there's a regular print, large print, and also in Spanish for our Spanish speakers. Also, the calendars for next year are also available. Beautiful calendars. If you want to get a jump on next year, feel free to take a calendar on the way out. Let us pray. In this celebration, O Lord our God, you have shown us the depths of your love for all your children. Help us, we pray, to reach out in love to all your people so that we may share with them the good things of time and eternity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
From the